If you've ever bought something online, you know how annoying it is to enter all those numbers on a credit card. It's pretty easy to mess up one or two. It's even more annoying for the people trying to charge the credit card so they can sell you things. Luckily, the designers of credit cards back in the day thought about this. All credit card numbers have to follow a kind of pattern, and there's an algorithm that uses the pattern to figure out if a customer has accidentally switched two numbers in their credit card. The algorithm has a similar structure to the code for calculating the sum of digits. It starts with a sum of zero and a count of zero, and then for each digit, starting from the right, we increment the count, and if the count is odd, we add the digit to the sum. Else, if the count is not odd, and the digit is less than 5, we add twice the digit to the sum. Else, if count is even, and the digit is greater than 5, we add twice the digit to the sum, and subtract 9. And then, after all of that, if the last digit of the sum is 0, the card number is valid. How would you write Java code for this algorithm? We'll give you the code for summing digits, so you can adapt it, and also, you have this credit card number that you can use to test. And here's a hint. Credit card numbers are too big to fit in an int. This problem is tricky. There are a lot of ways to write code which almost works, but not quite. It'll be very important to use a tester program. Also, you can write println statements to get an idea of what's happening while your code is running.